make it very simple, very, very strong, solid. I wish you to be solid in that. Okay. Before, 1 minute. Okay. Before I start, well, it's not. Here I'm not going to describe yani the text, no. First of all, remember what are the digits, what are the finger names, thumb. The other is pollicis. All pollicis longus at the distal phalanx. All pollicis brevis before the distal phalanx, somewhere. Maybe metacarpal base especially, number one. Phalanx, pollicis, thumb, index finger. Index finger.
Indices.
Indices. Indices. Okay. Middle finger. Ring finger. Why ring? For engagements. Ring finger. Little finger. Digiti minimum. Okay. This is number one. Number two.
Could you repeat the thumb thing? Ring is the longest.
Yes. The longest usually on the distal phalanx. The brevis back.
You mean the attachment?
The longest mean the long one. Brevis mean the short one. The small brother is brevis. Mm. Okay? Oh, abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis. One here, take that. Okay, this is number one. Number two, there are some, why I'm standing here, I'm sorry, there's dark. So you can see me here.
Okay.
Movements of the thumb. Movements of the thumb. This is anatomical position. Movement of the thumb is like this. Flexion.
Extension.
Thing like flexion, extension, go back here. Extension,
abduction,
opposition.
Abduction.
Before that, abduction,
adduction,
opposition.
Opposition. Subhanallah. Subhanallah is opposition. Okay. Again, flexion. Here. Flexion, extension, abduction. Adduction, opposition. This is movement of the thumb. Then, movement of the fingers. Flexion of fingers. This is flexion of what? This movement is called what? Flexion of metacarpophalangeal joint. Khalas. If I make it like this, this is normal arm. If I make it flexion at this, flexion at wrist. Okay? No flexion at wrist. Flexion at metacarpophalangeal joint. Then flexion at proximal interphalangeal joint. Then flexion at full interphalangeal joints. All. Make a fist. This is called fist. Fist. Okay? When we make fist, this elevation four. They are called knuckles. Knuckles. K N U U C K L E S. Knuckles. Okay, this is knuckles. What is knuckles? It's the head of metacarpal bones. It's the head of metacarpal bones. Yes, making metacarpophalangeal joint. But prominent are the heads here in this position. Clear now? We are going very slow. Huh? Yes.
Damn it.
Yes. Okay. Now I start with some pictures.
It's just some
camera. How about abduction?
Okay, good. So here, flexion, here, extension of fingers, abduction. Away from the midline. Here, abduction, here is the midline, away from midline. Away from midline. Here, this is the midline. So abduction, adduction. Good. If you are not interested, please tell me your number and because I don't need disturbance.
I'm sorry.
It's enough. Okay. Bones of the head. Scaphoid. Scaphoid means boat. You know boat in the Bahar? What boat? Arabic. Okay. This is like scaphoid boat. Bowl. Scaphoid. Boat like. Scaphoid?
Boat like.
Leonoid. Or leonate here. Tricotrial, pisiform. When you see the model, the tricotrial and pisiform are one on the other.
Yeah.
Okay? Like if this is circular pisiform and here is the last one, tricotrial, on the tricotrial you will found a circular. I will show you, no problem. So here, very circular is pisiform. So again, scaphoid, unit, tricotrial, pisiform, trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hamate. How you find hamate? Hamate has a hook. You can find on the model, here is a hook. So hamate is a hook. Remember, like Dr. Tariq says Salma, I don't say Salma. She, Salma is one, I need many. So she looks too pretty, try to catch her. Don't write in the exam, please. But try to remember the first names and you will not forget. Easy?
Easy.
Okay. Then, remember, the wrist joint is only made by radius, scaphoid, unit. Here, no direct connection of ulna with the wrist area, wrist bones. Akid, there is a disc here. Okay? But there is no direct connection of ulna with the wrist bones. Number one. After this, you have metacarpals. No name. Numbers. Number one. Number two. From thumb, we start. Number one.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Khalas. Phalanx. Proximal phalanx, distal phalanx. In thumb, two only. For other fingers, three. Proximal or middle or distal. Proximal, middle or distal. Proximal, middle or distal. Humerus is a long bone. Femur is a long bone. What about the classification of this bone?
Small, long bone.
It is a small, long bone. Excellent. Small, long bone or miniature long bone. What is a long bone? Long bone has a head, a lower end and a shaft. See, head, lower end and a shaft. So this is one of the small long bones. All of them, they are long bones. All of them, except this yani.
Short bones.
These are short bones. These are long bones. Head of the metacarpal, make your nuchal. I write it. Then, this joints, you can visualize, or here, the flexors area, you can visualize the joint areas. Clear now, bones? Skin of the palm is very thick. Why? To make your grips not slip. This is the beauty of the thickness here, number one. Number two, there is one superficial muscle in the hypothenar eminence. Okay, before hypothenar, this is thenar eminence. Eminence yani elevation. So thenar group of muscle mujud here. Hypothenar muscles here. Some small muscles here, we will see, don't worry. One by one, we will do everything.
So
thenar eminence, 1 minute. Thenar eminence, hypothenar eminence, some other lumbricals, interossei, palmar, or dorsal. So four here, four lumbricals, four palmar, four here. 20 total. Ashreen. Okay? Yes. Uh-huh. Later on. Coming. Wait. Then, here's the skin. In the skin, you know, 1.5 with ulnar nerve. Medial 1.5 with ulnar nerve. The lateral one, 3.5, 1 or 2 or 3.5, medial nerve. Then, on the back, ulnar here 1.5, same ulnar here 1.5. The remaining, radial. Radial nerve.
Wait.
Till Yomal Qiyamah. Do not forget the tips. They are not supplied by this nerve. They are supplied the nerves from here.
Even
the thumb. Median, not radial from here. No. Median half or ulnar half or ulnar full.
Mm-hmm.
The nail beds.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Wait, I'm going to explain. If you have any question, just raise the hand. Understand? Don't forget till Yomal Qiyamah that the flexor aspect will cover the nail beds. This is number one. The skin is very thick with deep superficial fascia. Here, I will sit and I will show you palmaris brevis here, this muscle. Palmaris brevis. When I remove the skin, I remove palmaris brevis because it is inserted into the skin. It is very superficial. So we cannot find palmaris brevis on any of the models or any of the specimens. So we will see 19 muscles, not 20. Number one. Then, superficial fascia, you know everything. Deep fascia will make, here, I told you deep fascia is like a sleeve.
Yeah.
Come, and now it will make more thick area here, flexor retinaculum, extensor retinaculum, in the hand, palmar aponeurosis, here. The palmar aponeurosis is like this, a triangular area with apex, base, and two margins, medial margin, lateral margin. The medial margin is here, the lateral margin, and now this will make four slips or divisions, and they are going to make in the finger the fibrous flexor sheath. What is fibrous flexor sheath? Here. This is called fibrous flexor sheath. Yeah, can you see this covered area?
Yeah.
Like this. This is fibrous flexor sheath. Why fibrous flexor sheath? Because here we have retinaculum. So the retinaculum will hold all the tendons to hold them in a proper place. Similarly, we need each tendon to be held in a proper place. So this is the reason for fibrous flexor sheath. Number two, if you open fibrous flexor sheath, what you will see? You will see this blue area first. This blue area. This is called synovial sheath. What is synovial sheath? If I make a finger cut like this, this is one finger, any finger consider. Proximal phalanx, middle phalanx, distal phalanx. Okay? Now, here is the tendon. In the center, here is the tendon, this one. Now, on the tendon, we have this blue area. What is this blue area? I will remove this to not make you confused. Here, like this. On the cut section, if I have a cut section of finger, it is like this. Cut section of my finger. Here is the bone. Good? On the bone, here is the tendon. On the tendon, there is a C-shaped sheath, C-shaped like this. But it is double layer. Like this.
Synovial.
Again, where? Mujood hina. Like this.
That's wrong. The
opening is
down. The base down. The C down. What is this?
Synovial.
This is synovial sheath. Here, outer layer. Here, inner layer. Good? Inside there is some fluid. Synovial fluid. Why? To make the movements without ihtikak, without friction. This is the purpose of this sheath here. Now, you can see all these sheath are finishing here. This sheath extend into the hand. Not even hand, even here in the arm. See here, forearm.
In the wrist.
In the wrist, yes. This is called alar bursa. This is called alar bursa. What is bursa? Bursa is a capsulated sheath-like structure which is compressed and flat, but the same fluid is mojood here. What is the importance? For diabetic patient, if you wish to do the blood sugars daily, use this finger, this, walla this. Any one of them is good. This use is likely to get, if infected, will reach the infection into the palm, even into the wrist. So this is a problem. For thumb, see the sheath is going here. Radial bursa. So don't use this for diabetic patients.
Middle fingers.
So use these three for diabetic patients. These are good. Even if the infection occurs, it is not going beyond into the hand. Be careful. Yes. This is number one. Then, yes, name some thenar muscles. This is thenar area. This is hypothenar area or hypothenar eminence. Eminence yani elevation. You sit down on the chairs or on the table. No problem.
My fascia. Fascia.
What fascia?
Thenar fascia.
Thenar fascia? It's the same like the fascia of the head. Nothing special here.
Radial
bursa, I told you here. Here is the radial bursa. This I told you. Here is the ulnar bursa. And here are the digital synovial sheets. Okay? Now, here are the thenar muscles. Yes.
Bursa is
synovial sheet. Extension of the synovial sheet.
Above the flexor sheet, above the.
Be careful. What above?
This one. What? The blue one is the synovial, right?
Blue one is the synovial sheet here. Here. This is synovial sheet extending into the hand as this structure. The name of this structure is ulnar bursa.
There is another sheet, right?
Fibrous.
Fibrous flexor sheet is the connective tissue sheet. This on it. See this?
Above the.
Yes, it is on the top of everything. And then there is skin and superficial fascia or deep fascia.
Is it the same content as the three?
Yes, the contents are the same. But this is only extension.
Yeah.
Otherwise, no other difference.
Thinner fascia, superficial fascia.
Yes, hand has skin, superficial fascia. Deep fascia in the hand is modified here, flexor retinaculum. Here, plane. Here, again, palmar aponeurosis. Here, flexor sheath. There's no special thing like fascia here, no special thing.
Synovial sheath only in this
one. And all the fingers. See. Why not? Why only? Here, blue. In the finger, name synovial sheath. So, synovial sheath of index finger, synovial sheath of middle finger, synovial sheath of ring finger, synovial sheath of little finger, extend into ulnar bursa, here extend into radial bursa.
Doctor, the synovial sheath in the palm has the same name?
Yes, same name. Okay. Thenar muscles. 4. Abductor pollicis brevis. Flexor pollicis brevis. Opponent's pollicis, adductor pollicis. We will see them one by one. Hypothenar muscle, palmaris brevis, we will not see. Why? Because it is very superficial. If I remove the fascia, it will go. So, now, if you remove this, now, use your symmetrical knowledge. Abductor pollicis brevis, abductor digitimini. Flexor pollicis brevis, flexor digitimini. Opponent's pollicis, opponent's digitimini. So easy to understand, easy to locate on the hand. I will show you the tricks. Don't tell anyone. Till many days. Then lumbricals are 4. Then palmar introsciae on the palmar aspect. Dorsal introsciae on the dorsal aspect. How they look? See, here is the trick. First one, abductor pollicis brevis. Opposite here, abductor digiti minimi. Aval here. Abductor. Second, flexor, second flexor. Good? Opponents, remove them inside opponents deep. Remove them inside opponents deep. Here, adductor, the last one. So again, for hypothenar eminence, abductor pollicis brevis, flexor pollicis brevis, opponent's pollicis, adductor pollicis. Good?
Yeah.
Here, same like abductor pollicis, abductor digiti minimi, flexor digiti minimi. Remove, put inside deep, opponents. And the fourth, palmaris brevis, khalas, remove already. Understand?
Yep.
Good. Again, see here. Abductor, flexor,
Adductor.
Where opponents? Inside. Here. See. Abductor, flexor, adductor, inside. See. Opponents. Same here. Abductor, flexor, inside. Opponents. And then palmaris brevis. No adductor here.
Adductor here.
Yes. Only adductor for the pollicis. Okay. Lumbricals are very special muscles. Small, thin, they have a unique feature. They arise not from the bone.
From tendon.
They arise from tendon. Tendon of what?
Profundus.
Flexor digitorum profundus tendon give origin to this muscle.
Mm-hmm.
Gave origin to this muscle. Another. So four lumbricals. Again, flexor digitorum profundus is the muscle which gives origin to this group of muscles. So four tendons will give you 1, 2, 3, 4 muscles. Lumbricals are where they are inserted. From here, they go back. See, they are going back. Okay? Back on the extensor expansion. What is extensor expansion? See, muscles are coming from here. Muscles are coming from here. Maybe I will show you what muscles. But think of extensor expansion first. Extensor expansion is a thick fascia which covers on the dorsum of all the fingers separately. Then it is hard. It is divided into 3 slips. 2 lateral, 1 in the middle. The middle finish at the middle phalanx. The 2 finish at the distal phalanx. This arrangement is for protection, for insertion of the tendons from here, and insertion of small muscles from here. Understand?
No.
Who said no? Okay. Extensor expansion is extended part of deep fascia on the dorsum of the fingers. Number one. Number two. Why it is mojood? For protection. How it is made? From the extensor tendon plus lumbricals interossei may enter the tendon and make it. Once it is made, it is thick initially, then it will make 3 slips. The 2 lateral for each finger will go to the distal phalanx, the middle one remains small and in the middle. Wait, if this is same like 3, I may not be able to extend or flex because here is the gap, so it gap will me allow me to flex. Otherwise, it will not do. Thumb knot like this. Other story. Leave it. Not, no extensor expansion. Clear now? Ha! What is the action of lumbricals?
Right
extension.
Lumbricals have a very special action. This is the action of lumbricals.
Right extension is the...
The flexion of metacarpophalangeal joint and extension of interphalangeal joint. This is one function of lumbricals. Remember, till Yomal Kiyama, do not forget this. Lumbricals have a function of flexion and same time some degree of extension. How? Flexion at interphalangeal joint, metacarpophalangeal joint. Flexion. And keep them extended. Interphalangeal joint. Do not forget this. This is the action. Number one. Number two. This is about the dorsal expansion I told you. Extensor expansion or dorsal expansion. Interossei. The name is like interossei between the bones. Inter yani between ossei bone. See between the bone. These are called palmar interossei. If they are mojood on this surface, when they are mojood here, they are called palmar interossei. Where palmar interossei? Between the bones. Which bones? Metacarpals. Okay? So first palmar interosseus, second, third, and fourth. Palmar interossei. Action. Always for, okay, see first the dorsal interossei and you will remember the actions. This is dorsal interossei. This is on the back of my hand. Dorsal interossei. Again, between the bones. The previous you saw have one head, one origin. Here, they have two origins.
Yeah.
Bipinnate. Now, what is the action of this? Remember this formula. Don't tell anyone. Write P-A-D and D-A-B dab. What is this? P Palmer for adduction. Dorsal for abduction. Now remember. Dorsal for abduction. Palmar for adduction. Pad and dab. Do not forget. Till Yomal Kiyama. These are the function of the small muscles. Lumbricals. Flexion. Metacarpophalangeal. extension interphalangeal. But the pad and dab formula, pad is here, palmar adduction, dorsal abduction of the fingers. Why I say abduction like this? In the midline, away, movement away from the midline, abduction my shoulder, abduction another shoulder. Here, where is the midline? The mid finger is the midline. So away from midline, abduction, towards the midline, adduction. Happy? Okay. This is what I needed to tell you before I start on the models. Okay. Now see here. Which nerve is most responsible in the limb?
Median.
Median or ulnar?
Median.
Yes, median. And here, mostly ulnar is involved. How to remember? Abductor pollicis, flexor pollicis, opponens pollicis, all with median. Plus, one and two lumbricals. Khalas. After that, everything with ulnar. So remember few of them, and then in the exam analyze, you know this, the remaining all. Don't write remaining all. If they ask you name, don't write this is supplied by median, remaining all. No, don't test our knowledge. Show your knowledge, show your strength. That this palmaris brevis, yes, digiti minimi and flexor and. This is like how to remember the nerve supply. This you know, I told you. Facial spaces in the head, I will show you on the models. Just see here, there are two type of septums here. Some books say only two septums. Like here, on the lateral side, first metacarpal, one septum here. Septum is going deep, yeah. How deep? See, here palmar aponeurosis. See, one septum going to head with this bone. One, this bone. And one in the middle. First, second, third metacarpal. Some books say three septums. Some books say two septums. But I believe in three. Why? Because if I believe in three, because see, here is another space, here is another space. So boundary of this space, boundary of this space. The names are mid-palmar space, hypothenar space. Okay? If I say the boundary of mid-palmar space, two septum, superficially, palmar aponeurosis, on the medial side, one septum, on the lateral side, the middle septum. So I believe in three. Some books say two, but I cannot understand how to. Okay, here I finish. Okay, before I finish, here is ape-like hand. You know this now, injury of median nerve. You know carpal tunnel syndrome, injury or pressure on the median nerve. Then you know ulnar nerve here, this part of hand, is superficial. Till yomal qiyama, another thing you must remember. The ulnar nerve is crossing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. And median nerve
deep.
Is crossing deep to the flexor retinaculum. Do not forget this. Okay? Till yomal qiyama.
What's this?
This is injury here. To show you possible injury to the ulnar nerve.
Come again. Come again. Say it again.
So what?
The
ulnar nerve is crossing, the main ulnar nerve is crossing superficial to the flexor retinaculum. The median nerve must cross deep to the flexor retinaculum. Remember this. When there is injury to the ulnar nerve, you will have claw hand. This is called maklab. So claw hand is like this. If I have injury away from the hand, I still have claw, but it is not very serious. I have an injury here, claw. I have injury here, more claw. I have injury here, full claw. It's difficult. This is about because of the paralysis of the intrinsic muscles in the hand. This is called crutch. I don't know what Arabic. Crutch. This is called crutch. If you have longer crutch than you need, it is going to damage the axilla here. The most dependent here will be radial nerve. So radial nerve will be damaged and the result is wrist drop. If the main radial nerve is damaged. If some superficial or distal branch is damaged, there is finger drop. This is called finger drop. The wrist is safe. The wrist is good. But finger drop. Here, if the main radial nerve is damaged, what other causes damage of radial nerve? Maybe fracture here of the shaft of the radius, because in the spiral groove is the nerve, or this is the condition which is called as, and this is the supply area for radial nerve. Hand is very special to diagnose this condition, Down syndrome. In the children, we normally have many, two creases here. The children, three, yes, maybe. They usually have one crease. Down syndrome, you can just diagnose from the hand. Down syndrome has one. This is called Simian line or Simian crease. Thank you. Now what we'll do? We will sit here and we will see the models one by one. What is the time? Light. Oh, enough time. Sure.